Hi, I'm Brendan Slade. I'm Director of Tools and Embedded Ecosystem at NXP Semiconductor. And I'm here today to talk to you about our new LPCXpresso 824 MAX board, which is the development board for our newly introduced LPC82X family. The board implements many of the features of the LPCXpresso V2 family of boards, but in a slightly smaller and simpler package. The board's based around the LPC824 device, which is the top-end device in the family, and that's in a QFN 33-pin package here. There's also a SimSys DAP debug probe based on another LPC microcontroller, and that also includes the embed functionality, so you can support that toolchain as well. The board has many expansion features in a very small package. There's Arduino Shield connectors here and here, and these can be used with a wide range of off-the-shelf boards. Here's one from ARM and another one from Adafruit. In addition to these, you can also use the LPCXpresso expansion connectors here and here. These also work with embed, and there's also PMOD available here too, and a prototyping area as well. So these expansion options give you full access to the many options available in the peripheral set of the LPC824. That includes the access to the new ADC features, the sophisticated state configurable timer block, and all the expanded GPIO. So there's an awful lot you could do in such a small board. The board also includes some other useful features. There's a reset button for the target down here. There's an ISP button, so you can force the device to boot in ISP mode from serial port, and a wake interrupt button as well. And of course, the tricolor LED up in the corner, which is very useful for visualization in your program development. The LPCXpresso 824 MAX is fully supported by the LPCXpresso IDE, which can be downloaded for free from lpcware.com. You also have other toolchain options, Kyle, IAR, and others. And you can connect an external debug probe, like one from Sega, for example, through this connector down here. All of those toolchain options will work with our LPC Open driver set, which includes chip and board level drivers and example code. So let's take a look at one of those examples now. So I've downloaded LPCXpresso and LPC Open from the LPCWare site, and I've already built the example I'm going to show you. That's FreeArtists Blinky. So it's using the FreeArtists operating system to blink the LEDs on the board. And it's a bit more of an interesting blinky because it runs three tasks to do that. So after building the project here, I can just hit debug. Now it's going to connect to the board through the onboard debug probe. Now my program has hit the breakpoint at main. You can see here's our three tasks that are being created here, one for each of the LEDs. And I can step through the code into a function and out back out of functions, or I can step over a function. And when I'm ready, I can hit go. And then the LEDs will start to circulate on the board. Well, that's the LPCXpresso 824 MAX board. You've seen all the great expansion options it has available. You've seen the LPCXpresso IDE and that it's freely available from lpcware.com, and all the other development tools options you have available as well. LPC Open is available at lpcware.com as well. So get the board and get creating. Thanks for listening.